Hey guys, my name is Drika, and for the past few months, there has been a Hypixel thread going around called the Pukicho hero idea. The last reply has been in November, and it is currently January, so I'm extremely late. However, I still wanted to give my opinions on this. So we're starting out by reading that this is going to be a hybrid hero. Now, my first impressions on that are, I would like to see another hybrid hero, especially rather than another ranged or another melee hero. We have way too many of those, and they all have the exact same thing to do. All you do as a ranged is you sit back and hold right click. All you do as melee is you spam left click and right click and then aim your two button. And that's pretty much all those heroes. However, as a hybrid, you have multiple different things to look for and aim. You have a mix of the aim of a ranged and the damage of a left click, or of a melee. I'm good. So I'd like to see another hybrid hero. In the description, it says Pukicho is a hybrid hero which is focused around speed. I don't think we need another one of those. We already have two heroes that are focused around its speed or mobility, and they both have their flaws because of it. The first one is Sanic, and we all know how bad Sanic is. And the second one is Pug, which Pug has some good parts to it, but it's focused so much on its mobility that if you mess even one thing up, sometimes you'll SD because of it. And that's way too much to worry about. However, I think mobility heroes are a good thing, but with there being too many of them, it doesn't give it too much of flavor that the two main mobility heroes have. But even if we were to see this be an actual speed-focused hero, I would see it, yeah. Now, going off to our right-click ability, Thundershock. Now, this is a hit-scan ability that charges a power the longer you hold it. So, pretty much, you hold your right-click for X amount of seconds until it gives you either the spam you want or the charge damage time you want. I could see that being good, however, with it being hit-scan, I just could not see an ability where you hold right-click, and then once you charge it up for as long as you want, you let it go on a hit-scan. I just can't see that. Point and click it's hard enough to focus on point and click, but with it not being point and click, it being click and then point, that's just, I can't see it being like that. But anyway, let's look at the damage time. So our tier one is 0.5 seconds to 1.5 seconds of charge time. Now this has a 3.5 damage ability. That is way too much for 0.5 seconds of charge time. That is the same amount of charge time as shoot, only 0.25 seconds off. So with there being 0.25 seconds of a difference between 1.5 damage, I can't see that being that much. For tier 2, we have 1.5 seconds to 2.25 seconds charge time. The damage is 6.5, which, once again, that's way too much. Definitely pull it back to around, I don't know, like 4, maybe? As that'd be similar to Karakot. For tier 3, we have a 3 second to 4.5 second charge time, and this gives you 12 damage. That is absolutely way too much. That's double Cryo's ability, which has almost the same amount of charge time or cooldown, whatever you want to put those as, for only like 6 damage compared to 12 damage. That 12 damage is way too much for just 3 seconds. And in fact, that just makes it a ranged hero itself. All you have to do is just camp somewhere and spam the tier 3s. You destroy them in only like 6 or 7 shots. It is absolutely absurd. Anyway, the knockback, it doesn't deal that much knockback. As tier 1 deals no knockback. Tier 2 is kind of like a Kai Blast, kind of like Momentum Stop. Tier 3 is kind of like Frostbolt. And then each of those gives a certain level of slowness for however long. Going on to the secondary, the Void Tackle. Now the Void Tackle is pretty much Bulk Charge. That's all it is. For our passive, we have every 80 damage that he does until dying, he gets 1.5 damage on Volt Tackle. See, the thing there is that makes you deal damage for extra damage. That could be a good idea, yeah, but that also encourages camping. And like we said, this character would have absolutely no problem with camping, as he just spams his right click. But anyway, he does a huge leap with his shift, and that's pretty much, I mean, I could see that. I could see that being used. That's pretty much Green Hood, Tin Man, and Pug combined. So you get the fact that you can only use it once before touching the ground again, and the same energy cost as Green Hood. And then its leap is just Overload and Pounce combined. That's pretty much it. And it deals 3.5 damage to anybody near it. That's just Overload. That's all that is, Overload. For the Smash ability, it does a discharge where it disables the secondary ability of enemies and gives the hero a speed boost, or Pukicho a speed boost. That is no. First of all, I can't see there being any way to disable the secondary opponent or the secondary ability of opponents. And would that work anyway? Well, that would be way too overpowered for none of the characters to be able to use their secondary. I mean, just imagine a hero that uses their secondary to be able to live. For instance, Shoop. Shoop would be so terrible against one of these characters. Whereas a hero that has strong damage in itself, like for instance, Voidcrawler, can just, like, he doesn't completely need his Teleboom. His Teleboom helps him out a lot, but he doesn't need his Teleboom. I can't see that being fair to all the heroes, or even possible to make. It has a 180 second cooldown, which, same as Bontmobile. If you were gonna add that, I'd say that's a good cooldown, as that is the longest cooldown you can have. I don't know. I can't see that being a thing. Anyway, this was my kind of rant about the Pukicho hero idea. I'm sorry if it doesn't go by what anybody else says or believes in it. I'm sorry, but I just can't see this hero being a thing. It is way too overpowered. However, the complete Pukicho hero idea, that could be a thing. You just have to have a little bit better moves, or should I say a little bit worse moves, because these are way too overpowered. Especially his primary, which is Thunder Shock, which is that hit scan type ability. That needs to go. And then the smash needs to be changed as well. But yeah, so that's my opinion on this. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all in the next video.